Hello traders and welcome back to another YouTube video. Today we are going to be talking about a very unique topic, which is going to be how to actually let our winners run when we have a trade that is going in our favor. Now, this is a very, very important topic, and some of the best traders in the world, both now and in the past, have built their kind of success off of the idea of letting those winners really run in your favor. I'm going to talk all about that topic today, and let's go ahead and get into it right now. Hey traders, welcome back to the YouTube channel. If you're here for the first time, my name is Nick and I share all sorts of free Forex content on YouTube. I share tips and tricks and things that I've learned in my own journey, as well as share my trades and analysis and research. So if you're new here and you're enjoying this sort of content, make sure you subscribe down below so that you can come back and see some more of this content in the future. Again, it's free, so why not? Let's go ahead and dive into the topic of today, which is going to be how to let our winners run. Now, I mentioned briefly in the introduction of this video that some of the biggest, most profitable trades ever have to do with letting your winners run. And it makes sense. You can take a look at any chart for the most part, and you can see some of these massive winners or massive runs in trends that we've seen in the market, right? So imagine, for example, if you were long on this gold market trend, look at this. This is a daily chart. Imagine if you had gotten in down here. Now, I know that is playing devil's advocate or playing hindsight bias, right? We already know what happened. We saw a massive trend to the upside. But the idea here is imagine if you did in fact catch that trade and you were in fact long on this particular market move. This move would have made a tremendous amount of profit for traders who were looking to be long on gold during this time. Obviously, anybody who has a brain would love to be in that trade. But today we're going to talk a little bit, how can we actually capture moves like this, and how can we be on the right side of a major market trend like this and really let our winners run? No matter whether or not you are new to trading or you're experienced to trading, you've probably heard the saying, let your winners run, cut your losers short. How exactly do we do that? Well, what it's going to have to do with, generally speaking, is going to be following the major trends of the market. What that means is buying strength and selling weakness. In other words, sometimes that might mean buying high and selling higher and selling low and buying back lower, right? Or covering your short lower. So what that means is that when the market is trending upwards, right, we would be looking to buy strength and join the trend. The old saying is the trend is your friend, right? Well, in a down market, in the contrary, right? If the market is moving downwards, we would be looking to sell into that market in favor of the dominant downward direction trend. Now, of course, this is easier said than done. A lot of times the market reverses and we see pullbacks and sometimes even full-on reversals. So we have to be careful about this. But again, the topic of the day is finding and capturing and holding on to those really big trend winners. What this entails, however, is that you're going to have a lot of losers along the way, right? If you were trying to catch the start of a big trend early, a lot of times the market is choppy or reverses and spends most of its time back and forth. They say apparently that, you know, markets trend about 30% of the time and they range about 70% of the time, meaning that they're back and forth for the most part. And every once in a while, you see these major market trends, whether to the upside or downside. So when we're looking to capture some major market moves, there's a couple ways that we can actually let our winners run. For example, we could trade pullbacks in favor of a market direction. We've got the 200 period, and if you've watched my channel for a little while, you know that I personally like the 200-day simple moving average as a overall filter or trend directional bias in terms of a market's move, right? So as this market was trending to the upside, let's say that you were in fact looking for a pullback, and as this market decided to pull back here, right, let's say that you got long and looked to join the move. Well, if you were buying here, right, and you held on to your trade, obviously it looked really good from there. But the idea is, how could we hold on to that winner without getting whipped out of a trade, such as this move right here? You know, maybe if you're trailing your stop, that might have pulled you out of the trade, and then you missed this major continuation to the upside, and you were only in for this tiny amount of trend. Well, there's some ways that we can do this, and I want to talk about some of the simplest concepts of using this. For example, one way to do this is to enter the market, you know, for example, when the market is moving with some moving average confluence factors, right? For example, if you have Here is your 50 simple moving average and your 200 is in the red. So you have 50 above, 200 below. Let's say that you decide that you're going to get long only when the market is moving to the upside and we see the 50 above the 200. Well, if you're trading in the direction of the market, you would have been holding this trade and let's say that you're not getting out of this trade until it crosses back under. Well, you can see we hold on to this trend for a tremendous amount of time and only really get out of the market. I guess you could make the argument either right around here, this may or may not have gotten you out, or for sure you would have been out right around here if you closed the trend or closed the trade at the end of the trend there, right? Look at how much movement we really would have captured simply by using a moving average crossover concept. Now, again, people will say, well, Nick, it chops back around sometimes, so you lose on the times when the market is doing this, right? Moving back and forth and you're stopping out a bunch. Well, again, the problem with trying to let your winners run, the reason it's so difficult for so many people to do is because mentally it's very, very hard or unusual to see a trend just really keep going and to hold on to it effectively, right? A lot of times people get nervous, they get scared, they close out their positions too soon, and they don't let the market truly let those market rips really happen or the market trends really happen. And so to let your winners run, it is in fact an art, and it also takes a lot of patience, right? There's times like this where you have a market that is indecisive and trying to ride the trend for all it's worth is not so easy when the market is back and forth. So one thing to at least consider is the market environment that you're in. Look for major breakouts. If you like trading breakouts, you could look for pullbacks. Letting your winners run really simply means giving the market room to run without stopping out of your trade too preemptively. So in the current situation with gold, right, we see a market ripping to the upside and people are saying, well, how would I hold on to a winner in this case? Well, let's say that you decided to get in on this pullback. Again, hindsight, I know that's a perfect scenario that you would have gotten in on a pullback like this one, right? But let's say that you get back and you're in on the 38.2. That looks like pinpoint perfect, but you guys get the point. Let's assume the best. We're in the market right now, and how do we get into this trade? Well, to me, if you're really trying to let that trade run, my personal opinion is not to trail your stop too tight. Because if you trail your stop too tight, then the market, a simple pullback, which may just be in favor of the overall market move, you might get pinged out of the trade, right? So letting those winners run and letting them really run for all they're worth means giving the market a little bit of room to kind of expand and pull back and make those normal market moves that we so often see. So let's say that you were in fact long here on this particular move. Let's say that what you do is instead of trailing your stop so tightly, one thing you could consider, right, maybe, let's say that you're in the trade here, maybe you trail your stop along the 200 SMA. And if you say, let's say it closes underneath, you're out of the trade, right? So for now, if you were long in this trade, look how much you still have downside for that stop loss, right? You're giving the trade plenty of room to run. And what that means is you might take some bigger stops and you might have to deal with stop outs on a more regular basis if you're trying to let those winners really, really run. But if you're looking to let that trade really run, giving it the room that it needs to kind of play out is sometimes required for those bigger trends. You have to be able to hold on with a longer term outlook on a trend. Let's say that you're going, you know, this is just kind of an arbitrary placement of the target, right? But to let that really run, you do have to give it plenty of room for normal pullbacks, right? None of this, you know, a slight pullback gets you out of the trade. You know, if we start to see a reversal or full on sign of, you know, maybe we start to see lower highs and we start to see signs of reversal, well, then maybe we consider closing out the trade differently. Kind of depends on what your own strategy is and how you like to enter and exit the market. But generally speaking, for me, when I'm trying to follow the overall trend and stick to the trend direction and let those winners run, I'm not going to stick my tight stop loss or my stop loss too tight. And I'm going to let that trade breathe a little bit and see if we can get that full, you know, multiple risk to reward factor, right? You have something like what in fact we could take a look at what this is actually. This is like a five to one reward to risk, right? Letting those bigger reward to risk trades play out is really kind of the key to letting those winners run. Now, there's also one more thing that I'd like to talk about in terms of letting your winners run. Sometimes the best way to let your winners run is not even to put a target at all. In fact, to let that trade run for all that it's worth, sometimes the best thing to do is not cap the upside, but only cap the downside. For example, let's say that you're long again on this market. All you do is you say, if price closes underneath this 200, then I'll go ahead and close out the trade. But until it does that, I'm going to let the trade run. So let's say that the trade continues and we really continue all the way up here. And, you know, finally we get to a point where we close underneath. Well, now you've captured a very large move just because we were not capping the upside and we were letting the trade run, right? That's another scenario that you could play around with. Of course, at the end of the day, make your own trading decisions. I hope you got something out of today's video on letting winners run. If you did, make sure you comment down below. Let me know what you think about the subject and subscribe to the channel if you're new for more free Forex related content. We'll see you guys next time.